Hello, today we will present to you an amazing VR headset that is Pimax Crystal. We'll check exactly what's squeaking in the grass and highlight its advantages and disadvantages. If you want to support us, go ahead and leave something in the comments and give a like. Seriously, it means a lot to us. So without unnecessary extension, let's get started. The Pimax Crystal goggles come in a reasonably sized black box. Upon opening it, we are even immediately greeted by the headset along with the controllers. Hiding deeper are the accessories buried in the corners, which are briefly cables and even more cables, mainly for connecting to the PCVR and charging. The rest of the accessories are instructions and as many as two replaceable batteries for the goggles. Starting with the controllers, they do not represent a design revolution. They are a pure ripoff of the MetaQuest model. We already know everything. So let's move on to the headset. It is definitely not one of the small ones. The futuristic design fits into its body and is sure to appeal to most users. The weight, with the size also goes the weight because it's as much as 1149 grams. That's more than a kilogram. It's a good thing that they took care of solid strap adjustment in the strap. Cushions and all sorts of sponges balance this weight problem in part. Such a load on the head may result in a shorter time of enjoyable gameplay or work. Nevertheless, a decent strap adjustment should help a lot. Buttonology is not a problem. Here we have the standard buttons for volume, turning on the device and separately switching modes between PCVR and Standalone. We also find a 3.5mm mini jack. In addition, we have electric lens adjustment, just like in the Pico 4. On the side, you can see a plug for plugging in the wiring from the PCVR, and on the back, we have a slot for a replaceable battery. The process of changing the battery is time-consuming, clumsy, and unfortunately, we will never do it with a smile on our face. However, there is one plus: the battery lasts from 3 to 4 hours of gaming, so you'll still have enough time to play on the headset before you will try to fight with changing the battery for the spare one. Moving on to the lenses and screen. Phenomenally working here is the unprecedented in goggles option of automatic IPD, which will automatically adjust the width of our eye span from 58 to 72 millimeters. Crystal also has a built-in eye tracking or eye movement tracking function. The screen itself is a powerful asset of the headset, a QLED type screen with a resolution of 2880 by 2880 for just one eye. This is an unprecedented resolution in consumer goggles. We are talking about as much as 35 PPD. Vivid colors and the ability to adjust their clarity in the settings is an amazing option. Even more interesting is the ability to change the FOV from 120 to as much as 140 degrees. Of course, as we mentioned in the previous material, the larger the FOV, the smaller the PPD. We recommend reading our little compendium of knowledge. You will find the link in the description. In other words, wanting to maintain the best image quality, it is worth staying at 120 degrees in FOV, but 140 degrees for a big application, for example in aviation simulators or in simriching. The image frequency is not bad either, because depending on the settings, we can choose from 90 Hz to as much as 120 Hz. Demanding amateurs of a clear image with a good FOV and refresh rate will certainly love such a specification because it is vain to find it in the competition. The further into the woods, the more interesting it gets. The manufacturer allows us to play in standalone mode without the required connection to a PC. We have two processors on board. One is the Qualcomm Snapdragon XR2, known from other high-quality VR goggles. On the other hand, the second processor chip specially created by Pimax is exclusively for more efficient operation with PCVR. Interesting things are yet to come because in addition to the 6,000 mAh external battery, we have a small integrated 120 mAh battery, which works only for startup support when connecting to the computer, and quickly dies because the manufacturer uses it alternately for many short processes or combines its operation with the external battery, which requires both to be charged. The standalone mode is still in beta. You can see that this is not the most important functionality Pimax focused on when developing these goggles. In addition to controllers twinned to those of the Quest from Meta, We also have a similar layout of icons or pass-through functions with border drawing. Does Pimax need base stations to operate? Well, it doesn't. Its sensor and camera system allows us to do the same as in the aforementioned Quest, Pico 4, and other well-known and well-liked headset. As for VR applications and games, the dedicated ones, specially created for Pimax goggles, are quite unoriginal, and their quality does not knock you out. Here we have, for example, Audio Trip, the Chinese equivalent of Beat Saber or Dragon Fist VR Kung Fu, which is a kind of Tekken in VR version. The proprietary applications here are nothing to praise Pimax for, they still leave a lot to be desired. Fortunately, we can use VR games and applications available on the Steam platform. PCVR itself does not disappoint. The perfect synchronization with Steam VR further emphasizes this. It is here that we can languish over the quintessential quality of top VR goggles. The image incredibly affects the imagination and allows us to be transported to a pre-selected game without sacrificing pixel quality, because we have far more pixels than the rest of the competing devices. Games work without any glitches or any glitches. A stable connection via cable allows uninterrupted fun with the goggles. We also won't experience any problems with the controllers, because these will last for many hours and even days on a single set of batteries. Certainly, cabling can be a limitation to movement, and the possibility of getting tangled in a pile of cables does not sound like a recipe for fun, more like an expensive mistake. One would like to connect conveniently and remotely to the PCVR. Unfortunately, at this point, we can only do so via a physical cable connection with a computer. It is rumored that in the future, Pimax Crystal will have a dedicated PC attachment to support remote use of the PCVR. On the other hand, the speakers should be able to cope and will satisfy most users. You can hear all clear as well as treble and bass. There is always the possibility of plugging in separate headphones. The microphone is average. There is no frenzy, but it can be heard in the game. If we want to use Crystal primarily to play VR simulations, the built-in speakers and microphone should be enough. Who is Pimax Crystal actually for? Such a question is bound to be asked when we first see its dizzying price of about 1,900 euros. If we disregard such disadvantages as its large size, because it weighs several times more than the competition, poor standalone mode and a certain noise it makes during operation, we are left with a headset that is a dream piece of equipment for hardcore gamers. Let's look at it from this side. We have at our disposal an amazing pixel density per degree, or 35 ppd, which translates into incredibly good image quality. Excellent FOV of 120-140 degrees, and refresh rate of up to 120 Hz, which increases the sense of immersion. These are parameters which together, or even separately, you can't find in vain in similarly priced VR headsets. What we are dealing with here is a headset that will mainly find its niche among the most demanding VR users, namely those who love aviation or car simulators. In addition, eye tracking, automatic IPD adjustment, and no requirement to mount base stations, as well as literally seamless synchronization with Steam VR, turns Pimax into the ultimate gaming machine for AAA titles and more. The manufacturer continues to develop the software and indicates that it will be adding improvements to at least standalone mode. This makes us very optimistic, and we love to see how it's getting so much progress from time to time. Thanks for being with us. We recommend taking a look at our other VR content. Stay tuned.